Hello, hello, hi. Welcome back to my channel, you guys. I was just, thank you for coming. So this video, we're going to be going over this is the second part of the palette mixing tutorial. And here, as you can see, I'm doing the other side of the dress of the sleeve. And this is going to be a Renaissance, realism fantasy painting, or you can say it's a Renaissance fantasy realism painting. And so I just wanted to just take a moment out in doing a video like this, just to kind of show you my palette mixing, the pigment colors, what I'm doing with ultramarine blue, and the titanium white. If you have not seen the part one to this video, the palette mixing video, please take a moment to go back to that part one video and see that one first, continue on to the next here to this video, or you can actually watch it, you know, out of order, however you will. As you can see here, I was just showing you my glazing effect and approach to drawing, or actually painting rather, fabric. And then for this dress that the principal figure will be wearing in the painting, it is going to be a very Renaissance, very Elizabethan period dress costume. And I actually very rarely draw paint fabric. I have in the past, but almost, you know, rarely, because I'm doing, most of the time I'm doing portraits. But this is actually one, this is a big painting that where I am going to be approaching and doing a lot of fabrics and a lot of layering of the fabrics. The fabrics. So yeah, the layering of the fabrics, you know, it's really important when you get into the layer of the pair, you're doing a painting involving like layerings of fabrics, most especially a Renaissance Baroque style painting. There's gotta be lots of glazing, and you're going to have to really take your time in doing it. It's just a time. It's going to take at least 2 to 3 weeks at the most, if you're working on it every single day. One of the painters that I really looked, I am quite inspired by, and I really look up to this type of form of painting, would definitely have to be, you got it. Rembrandt. And then there's also a contemporary painter who he's greatly inspired by, the Flemish or the Dutch Golden Age, and his name is Odd Nerdrum, and he's still alive. He's alive. And he's from Norway. He's a very famous Norwegian figurative painter. He paints very large, very large style, beautiful paintings. And it's very reminiscent, and it has that echoing like homage effect to that of Rembrandt. Please check him out. Odd Nerdrum, that's his name, and his paintings are just really wonderful. It really does take that layering piece of just not becoming impatient, and you see the magic happen before your eyes. The fabric actually starts to become very, you know, tactile and real, instead of just brush strokes. The brush strokes will eventually turn into very tactile forms of images, and that's the best way I can explain it to you. Because you're not going to get this tactile style 3D, you know, type image, you know, within working on it for 2 or 3 days, unless, I mean, if you're working at 8 hours at a time, like say you paint 8 hours within one day, like 4 hours in one increment, and 4 hours in another increment, morning, afternoon, morning, and then afternoon, 4 hours each. And then for the next 2 days, you're doing the same thing. And so that's like 8, 8, and 8, 16. You know, that's, you know, I will say to you that you most definitely could really get a fine result of a very realistic 3D tactile looking, I mean, fabric that you could just kind of just pick right off the canvas and put it right on. So, but for me, that's that time scheduling is not going to work for me because, you know, being a wife and a mom, you know, to six kids, and I'm homeschooling at the same time, I have to actually build my schedule around what is the main core of the scheduling that's going on in the house. So, and most primarily, that's the kids. So, this is not going to be a very long video. I'm going to be wrapping up here in just a few minutes, or maybe a few seconds rather. Please take the time to go back and look at any of my tutorials that are on here on my channel. Please subscribe and like them. You know, take your time and just watch a lot of real. There's a lot of tutorials on the anatomy of building a face, to that of the anatomy of painting a realistic hand, to that of, you know, those are all helpful videos that I just really want to share with you to hope for you to become a better artist, a better painter. So I look forward to seeing you on our next video. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Hi, thanks guys for stopping by and seeing my wonderful, awesome tutorials. I love to see you guys again. Thank you for liking, subscribing my channel and the videos. You can also follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and also there's my official website at zenkiea.com. If you want to buy any type of new art deals, any drawings, paintings, they're all there for you to see. It'll follow you over there. Just follow it over to the square.com website where you can actually buy and make purchases of everything. Thank you so much for stopping by, and I will see you next time. Bye. Peace out.